Hi, today I'm going to go over XML Notepad. XML Notepad is a tool that's been around for a while, and it's really useful for folks that either don't want to interact directly with XML because they don't have a comfort level with it, or they want to take advantage of some of the additional features that come with the XML Notepad tool. This is a free tool provided by Microsoft, and a link to it is available in the description of this video. So I already have up a XML instance. It's a 15100 instance file. And if you look at the left, you'll see that there is a view of the entire file as a tree. And we can both expand and collapse parts of the tree. It's also nicely color-coded. The items in red are attributes. The items in blue are character data. And then the little folders represent elements that contain additional elements, so nested structures. So this is a real nice way to view your XML, particularly when you have a bigger file. But the real advantage of the tool is some of the capabilities that come when you attach a XML schema file. So I'm going to go ahead and do that by clicking View, Schemas, and I already have one saved here, but if you didn't have one, you just click the ellipsis and select the schema you want to use. First thing you'll note is that we now get the error list populated with errors. Hopefully there are no errors and it would not be populated, but I added an error just so we could go through this exercise. So if we double click on this, it brings us to the item that is failing to validate. And what's nice about the tool, again, is because it has access to the XML schema, it knows the domain of values for many of the enumerations. So locality is not a valid value. I'm going to change this to township. And then the error goes away. Another nice benefit is the dynamic help. So if you click on particular items, you'll see that it populates the documentation from the XML schema. Another way to familiarize yourself with the format. Finally, I'm going to go through the find function, which can work as a standard find, but the real value here is the ability to execute XPath expressions. And I have one saved up to find the contests that don't have selections in them. So this could be valid in the case where there's a contest where no one filed, but if you have a lot of those, that could also be an issue. So we can hit find next and it brings up a contest that does not have contest selections. And we can keep finding next and go through the list as needed. So this has been a demonstration of XML Notepad, a nice little free tool that you can download and use and interact with your CDF files. Have a nice day.